guys. Oh my god, I look so gross. Anyways, so made myself a burger, and then I have leftover fries that my sister made earlier. Some juice and water. But that's not what we're here for. I completely forgot to give you guys updates on the books that I was reading for the Asian Readathon. So I was only able to finish 2 books. Not bad. So yesterday, on the 31st of March, I finished Shang-Chi by... do you see the author's name? I know who the author is, but I forget their name. By Jean Luen Yang. Sorry about my pronunciation. I think the author of this one was the author of Boxer and Saints. I think so. This was not on my original TBR, I don't think. But I was like, I need to get at least one other book done. So I picked this one because it was a comic. So I think I gave this 3 stars on Goodreads. It wasn't bad. It wasn't good. It was just like okay. Pretty much this was like following the character Shang-Chi through... I'm gonna call him Jean, through the author Jean's perspective, I believe. I know absolutely nothing about this character, and I don't really know if I learned anything about this character. I feel like this is more meant for people who already know who this character is and stuff. Like, I kind of got a basic idea of who this character is and stuff. I'll be honest, I only read this to get an idea of what the movie's gonna be like, because one of my favorite actors, Simu, I forget his last name, is gonna be playing this character for the Marvel movie, which I think comes out in like December or something. And I know the second book in this series is supposed to come out towards the end of the year as well. And I'm like, I want to at least get like a basic idea of what this story is about. So I read this. I don't know if it really helped me, but yeah, I thought it was interesting. I don't really know. I didn't really like the art style. It's not really my thing. So that was a negative. The story was a little hard to understand because there were so many points where it's like, go back to this comic, go back to this thing, which really bothered me. And just, that was something that really bothered me. And I'm like, I don't have the time for that. It's just, I wish they kind of explained it a little bit or had something in the back that would explain that for people who are maybe just reading this and don't actually own the other comics that they were mentioning. So that was also something annoying. Oh, I forgot to say the title is Shang-Chi Brothers and Sisters. It's the first one in the series that Jean is writing. So yeah. Pretty much this story follows Shang-Chi trying to stop his, I don't know if they're biological siblings, I think they're half-siblings, his sister who took over reign of their father's like cult thing, and trying to stop that. That's pretty much, I think, I guess you could say the basic idea of the story, which was cool. It was interesting. It was definitely interesting to see like the, I guess, aspects of Chinese culture. I don't really know if there was much, but there was that. So yeah, it was okay. Not my favorite, not the worst thing I've ever read either. So yeah, 3 stars. And then the best book I've read this month was the last book in the Orange manga duology, and 5 out of 5 stars. Love this. I very much did enjoy the ending, and I was really happy with the way the author ended it. It's kind of interesting to see like what would have happened if he chose like a different route, but I did really enjoy the ending. This was so fucking sad. My god, was this sad. I really should not have read this in public because, girl, I wanted to cry so many times. The series is just so sad. Also, I kind of ruined my book when it was in my backpack. It was a lot worse. Like, it bended a lot more. Also, I just have, like, a bookmark in here because I kind of want to look at the extra, like, manga in the back. But, really enjoy this. I love their friendship. It's so, like, you could just feel how genuine their friendship is. And it's just so cute. But it's so sad as well. So sad, but yeah, I really enjoyed this. Can't really talk much about it without spoiling it, but I'm gonna be honest, I really want to know what happens in the future with all these characters, like just like a special manga where you can kind of see like what happens. Like, I think like this is supposed to be like their selves 10 years in the future, so I want to see that, but with the updated like ending and see what actually happens after that. That's just one thing I wish, like, instead of putting all these random mangas, they put that. That's just something I really want to see. Like, I just want to know what happens to these characters. Do they actually include that? No, it says something about an astronaut, but anyways, yeah, that was just the one negative I could find. I just wish we could see that, but yeah. So we finished 2 books. I don't know what the total was and what challenges those fulfilled. Yeah, it's June 1st, so happy Pride Month to everyone. Stop. I'm actually getting my vaccine this month, so love that. Get vaccinated if you're able to. Please wear your goddamn masks. Anyways, Yeah, I don't know what else I can mention that I can think of. Oh, I finished two K-dramas. I finished The Ethereal Chronicles. I don't know how to pronounce it. I need season two. The way they ended that. Oh, the way they ended season one. Apparently last year they did get picked up for a second season, but there's literally no updates of the show. So there's that. Oh, Alice in Borderland is getting a second season, and I think it comes out this year, or it's probably next year, like early next year, which I cannot wait for because my god. I also finished Move to Heaven, which was super cute. Loved it. Kind of a little gross because like it deals with like death and stuff, but it was so cute. But the ending, I don't really gotta end it like that. I at least want to know what happens after, like the fuck. Anyways, and apparently my cousin told me Attack on Titan is back on Netflix, so I'm eating my burger while watching that because I've been wanting to watch it and I want to get caught up so I'm there with everybody else when the last season comes out, because I'm like, yeah. So I'm gonna check if it's actually on Netflix because I really want to watch it. I've rewatched Spirited Away. Love that movie so much because it's on Netflix. I'm so happy that Canadian Netflix has the studio Ghibli or Ghibli. I never remember what the pronunciation is. Movies, because I can finally watch them. My Neighbor Totoro and Spirited Away are my two like favorite ones. I watched Spirited Away with my siblings. I think my one sister liked it. My little brother was a little creeped out by it, but I don't really know if I have anything else. Just really been busy with work and school. I actually have class today in an hour maybe. So yeah, but I'm gonna eat my burger while watching Attack on Titan. So. BTS meal, we got the bag. So cute. I like how they added the Korean on it too. Like, I don't know, I just love it. It's cool. Yeah, I got just a normal meal with the nuggets and stuff. My drink has, I always mix my drink. There's Sprite, root beer, strawberry Fruitopia, orange Fruitopia, Nest tea. What was the other one? There was one more. I forget what the other one was. But yeah. And it looks like, my sister says it looks like apple juice. My fries! Oh man. I'll be back. But yeah, my sister says it looks like apple juice. But anyways, I'm also on episode 3, season 3 of Attack on Titan. Y'all, I got so much I need to update y'all on that I haven't done. I have finished 3 books? No, 4 books? I don't actually know. Let me look on Goodreads. Oh, wait. My laptop's still broken and, I'm using my little brother's laptop, so I'm too lazy to re-log into Goodreads, so I'm not gonna do that. Anyways, I know I finished the first 2 volumes of Ruby, which I gave 5 stars to both. Loved them. I remember when I was in high school, because of one of my friends, I watched I guess you could call it the anime, and I really liked it. I just don't know if I actually ever finished the anime, or I just stopped keeping up with it, even though I really did enjoy it. Like, it was really cool to watch. But yeah, I wanted to, I guess, just refresh because there was the manga, so I was like, I'll read it. And I could remember quite a few things from having watching the show, which is shocking because my memory is usually disgustingly bad. But anyways, so yeah, I finished those 2. Then I finished, did I talk about Living with Mochi? I don't think I have. It was like a graphic novel just about the author getting their dog Mochi, which is I think a pug. I don't know, I just thought it was a cute book. I think I gave it 5 stars. I'll like put up the actual thing that I gave it and the picture of the book. Sorry, I need to find my hair clip because my bangs are bothering the hell out of me. But anyways, what else did I read? Then I read, oh, I just finished Oh My Gods, which I gave 5 stars. It's just like a graphic novel on like Greek mythology, but like the author's like, I guess, modern take on it. Pretty much like the character, sorry about my chair, lives in New Jersey. She doesn't know that she's a demigoddess and that her dad is, I'm assuming he's supposed to be Zeus because they call him Zed, like Z-E-D. I'm assuming he's Zeus. So yeah, her dad lives in Mount Olympus and her mom lives in New Jersey. So she goes from New Jersey to Mount Olympus, has no idea what the hell is going on. So yeah, it's kind of like that kind of story. It's just a cute story. It was fun to read. And I love the artwork and I love how there was like diversity within the Greeks, like gods and like characters and stuff, like from the way that they look. So it was nice. And I like that there was also diversity with the people who wrote the book. I know the artist, I believe, is black. And then the, wait, let me get the book actually. So this is what the book is. So let me see. It says Issa Fitzpatrick. From their picture, like they have like artwork, but from their picture, it looks like they could be black, but I don't know. And then I'm assuming the actual artist of the book, Juliana Moon, is Latina. And then I don't know what the author's ethnic background is. But yeah. I think this whole book was done by females. Well, like, I know the writer, the artist, the two writers and the artist, I believe, are all female. Yeah, I think they're all female, so. That was also cool, but, yeah, I just thought it was a fun book to read, and, like, the, like, artwork and stuff is just cute to look at and stuff. And then I also started a new book today. I got my shirt. God, then bring me! My one friend who's not much of a reader recommended it, and I'm like, if somebody who's not much of a reader says that this is one of their favorite books, I'm gonna read it. And it's The Night Fairy by Michael Bottham. I'm on page, let's see, 16 or 17, one of those two. And it's interesting, but I have no idea where this plot is going, to be quite honest. I think I can see where it's going, but I don't know. I didn't read the description because I usually, with like thrillers and stuff, I usually like going in it blind because I don't want to know what's happening. So yeah, but finally today on June 11th, everything or lockdown is like, I guess you could say, like kind of over. We're like in stage one or something. I don't know what is going on. All I know is that the stuff that I've been waiting for, like the birthday section in Walmart, is finally opened because I had to get something for my friend as a birthday gift and a birthday card, but everything was closed, so I could finally get that today. But my God, it's so hot, like it's really nasty hot outside. I was dying and I had to wait in line because there's lines again, and I'm like, this is something I did not miss with lockdown. But yeah, I don't know if there's anything else I need to mention. I'll probably figure that out later. There's probably books that I'm missing that I haven't talked about, which I'll probably do later. But I am watching Attack on Titan, which,
fuck, it's so good,
because Netflix finally put season one back on. But only season one, which is so frustrating. But anyways. See, I watched season one with my cousin, and now we're just watching all the other seasons together. Because she's already watched it, and I want to watch it with her. Because why not? Because I want to be caught up for when the final season comes. Because I'm like, why not? So, but I remember watching it. And honestly, I feel like I had already finished season one. But I had not continued after that. Because like, while I was watching, I'm like, I remember so much that happened, which I'm just like, again, my trash memory. I don't know how that works. But yeah, so we're on season 3, part 1, I think. Because I think she said season 3 and 4, like part 1, part 2. So yeah, I'm just waiting for her to message me back so we can start watching together. So yeah. Yesterday was the last day of my summer class, like for Zoom. So, but it was so frustrating because we were doing like group projects. We were like presenting. Literally, when I say literally, as I was about to present with my partner, the internet cuts off, so it kicks me out of the Zoom meeting. I'm just like, you have got to be kidding me, at the worst possible time. Why? So there was that. I was so frustrated because of that. Like, I was like, But yeah, we got that done. So I'm done with those Zoom meetings. So technically the class is not over because I still have to finish one part of the group project. I don't know what exactly it is. And then I have an individual assignment for that class. And then I also have my one exam for my Italian class that I'm in that I need to finish. But I have until like June 21st to do it. And it's not going to take me that long. I just need a little break. But yeah, I had work today. I don't work until Monday, so I get a little bit of a break. I feel like I've finished some K-dramas and like TV shows or something. Again, I'll mention it later. So until whatever the next clip is, peace for now. Some Timbits. My little sister made some poutine. It looks weird. The chicken Chipotle wrapped. Very cold by now. I love this juice. Water, obviously. And the donut. Yay. I also did get the strawberry lemonade, which so good, but I finished it on my way home. This is fucking hot outside, but I figured I'd try this donut. I forget what it's called, but it looks cute. But yeah, it's 6:26. Hopefully if my cousin answers, oh, it's literally just like a donut hole, donut, without an inside, but just means that I'm right here. Woo, there's filling in the inside. Ooh. Mmm. That's good. That's really good. Gotta get Kleenexes. Anyways, I was gonna say my cousin's answers, we're gonna finish off last season of Attack on Titan. Girl, when I tell you, I cried. So like, actually I didn't actually cry, but girl, the amount of times I wanted to cry because of certain people who died, I was like, my cousin was not lying when she said the show writer will kill off whoever he wants. Anyways, man, we're watching the part one of season four, since part two doesn't come out until, honestly, I don't know, but apparently the manga is finished, so, like, if I wanted to, I could find out the ending right now, but that's not gonna happen. I probably, if I can get my hands on the manga, which probably will not happen, I'll read it, but she says it's very different, like, not the same to the anime, so it's, like, I kind of want to wait, but there's spoilers literally on any social media app you go to, there's spoilers, so it's like I don't know how I wasn't spoiled for like any of these characters' deaths when in The Walking Dead I'm getting spoiled with everything. So yeah, and like TikTok and Twitter are the two places I'll be getting spoiled everywhere. But yeah, so we'll see with that, but I'm really enjoying it. It's so good, so good. But yeah, might do updates more later, but I'm gonna go and eat, so peace for now. Thank you.
that much taste.
Did you put too much water?
This is the normal amount of water I put. It's not that bad.
Just realized I said I was gonna do a taste test of my tea on camera and I just tasted it without realizing, but it's actually really good. I don't know how to describe the taste, but it's not too bad. The smell, not my favorite, but the taste is pretty good. I'm so stupid. I'm like, literally as I took a sip, I'm like, wait. Anyways. Supposed to be in there, but all I taste is guava. It's like a
thank you.